Hi guys, welcome to my first video ever. As you can see, I grabbed myself some wine, so feel free to get something to drink, whether it's alcoholic, non-alcoholic, or whatever your preference. So I'm going to mainly focus on true crime in Australia, South Africa, and New Zealand, as this is quite close to home. And for any suggestions or anything to make this channel or this videos more enjoyable for you guys, please put any suggestions in the comments down below and I will be sure to read them. For my very first story, I'm going to cover a case that happened quite recently in South Africa. So it's very fresh and it hit South Africa quite hard. Just to put in a disclaimer here, I don't mean any disrespect to a family or friends, anyone I'm speaking about in this video. I just want to get a story out there and state the facts. This case will be a missing solved case, as the alleged killer already gave himself up. So this is not going to be the longest of videos I'm shooting, but for the first I think it's a good case to cover. The name of the victim is Wanene Mngutshana. She was a first year film and media student at the University of Cape Town, and according to a friend she was a very fun and funny person, fun loving person, ambitious. She wanted to travel and see the world. I'm sorry, this is my cat Cake. He will be in some of the videos as he is very nosy. According to a friend, she was just a fun, funny person, lovely to be around, ambitious, wanted to see the world, always had a helping hand to lend, and according to her uncle, she was the favorite in the family. On Saturday, 24th of August, she went to the post office at around 12. That's also where she has last been seen. A man at the front working told her that the power was off, or that the card machine isn't working, and that she has to come back at 1. And the problem with that is the post office closes at 1 in South Africa. So more background information about this man working at the front desk. He is a 42-year-old black male. He was previously convicted of armed robbery, which he served 4 years of an 8-year sentence of. And he was also accused of rape, but that was withdrawn for unknown reasons. This was quite a funny and interesting story because according to the media, he went to the hospital to visit his girlfriend, but then he couldn't find his girlfriend, so he chased after another woman to rape her. But like I said, the case was withdrawn for unknown reasons. When Nene went back to the post office at 1, like he instructed, and conveniently all the other staff members had already left except for the 42-year-old man, he then asked her if he can assist her at the back for searching her parcel. So when they got to the back, he groped her and raped her and she started to fight back. The one thing she did, she actually kicked him in the genitals, and he didn't like this. So he grabbed something and knocked her unconscious. When she came by again, he then grabbed the post office scale and bludgeoned her to death. He then took her body and threw it in the back of his car and drove home to decide what to do with her body. He firstly wanted to burn her, but that didn't work out for him, so he decided he's going to dump her somewhere. So he drove to Lingerlethu West, which you can see from the map. It's 45 minutes from the Claremont post office. Which makes this quite depressing is that Yunene never wanted to go anywhere alone. This is what one of her friends said.
She asked me if I can accompany her to Cavendish. And I looked at her funny like, Yunene, Cavendish is right across the road. And she's like, no, Joyika, the stares I get from these men. And I was like, okay, I just didn't understand, but you know what, Uyinene, I always said I would do anything for you, so let's go. And then we went to Cavendish, and we went to Woolworths. We did her grocery shopping, but I was rushing her because I had guests back at Rez. And I was like, Uyinene, you're wasting time. She's like, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry. It's just that I can't go by myself. I just never understood. Why?
She was reported missing on the Saturday and her friends started handing out flyers looking for her everywhere, which is very sad because they handed out flyers especially in front of the post office. So the whole week he sat in the post office and looked at her friends searching for her desperately and said nothing. Except on the Friday, so this is almost a week from her going missing, he gave himself up and admitted to raping and killing Wanene. This was such a huge shock for her family and friends. And one of the statements he said to the police was, and this is a direct quote, "Yo, that girl gave me trouble. She took forever to kill." And I mean, that just gives you an idea what goes on in his mind. allegedly did try to rape someone before at the post office, a woman came forward named Alice Cropper. She actually told the news that she, just a few days before this happened, that she went to the post office at 4:30, and the same man told her that the power was off and the card machine isn't working, she has to come back at 5. And luckily for her, she kept on asking him to try and try again for a card. And she escaped where she could have been in the same shoes as Wenene. A huge vigil was held for Wenene at the University of Cape Town for friends, family, university students, and everyone just came together to just honor this lovely girl. A scholarship was also opened in her name at the University of Cape Town, and the post office was slammed with letters and flowers and everyone just giving their condolences to her friends and her family. I feel so sorry for her friends and her family, and I really just can't believe that these people out there, and we have to live in a world where we know such people exist. So please be careful and look out. Nowadays you can't even, in the middle of the day, go out somewhere, so please be safe. My utmost condolences goes to Wenene's friends and her family, and I hope you find peace, and I hope you find justice for Wenene. If you want to join the trending hashtag for a post on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, wherever you want to, there's a trending hashtag going around, hashtag justice for Wenene. So that's it from me, guys. Sorry for this very short video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you made it this far, please give it a like and a subscribe. If you have any suggestions to make this content any better, please put in the comments down below and I will be sure to read it. So until next time, guys, thank you for watching.